Hello, my sweet summer children. I'm back with some juice to get you through the long night. I'm still not quite over season 7, episode 6, and I'm just thinking, can it get much worse? And yeah, the reality of that question is yeah, it actually has to. If you've never read George R.R. Martin's original outline, then this video could contain potential spoilers or not. The outline changed significantly, but some of the outline remained true. And the part of the outline that I think is 100% true is who the survivors will be. Now, I've wrote stories. I'm currently writing the second book of a trilogy, and I will probably never let anyone read it, so please don't ask me. But I start with an outline, and while I'm writing, a lot changes as well because you get good ideas along the way. But one thing that I've never changed in any story that I've written is the broad fate of main characters. I might change the process or minor plots that I planned. Like if I plan for a character to die, they will still die, but they might not get stabbed. They might get quartered. I don't know. Just an example. It is always possible to change the fate of a character, but George R.R. Martin is a meticulous writer. He plays zero games when it comes to writing. He doesn't like to use outlines. Outlines cause him to lose interest. But even if you didn't write an outline, in your head, you know roughly how you want your story to end and who you want still standing at the end. So if you've read his outline, there are 5 main characters that survive all of the books: Bran, Arya, Tyrion, Jon, and Daenerys. In his outline, he describes his story as kind of a generational saga. I think that it's a coming of an age story about Tyrion, Bran, Arya, Sansa, and Jon. It's about them and how they changed the world. But yeah, I think the story can change from an outline, but I don't think what the whole story is about is going to change. And the story is about Bran, Arya, Tyrion, Jon, and Daenerys, how they grow and change the world. With that said, I could be totally wrong, but I don't think so. I think if we look at the story, those set up best for survival at this point are Arya, Bran, Jon, Dany, and Tyrion. But season 8 is going to be brutal. The actor that plays Jaime Lannister hinted at main characters becoming white. Totally believable. It's actually foreshadowed in Jaime's weirwood dream that he will fight the White Walkers with Brienne at his side. This dream occurs in A Storm of Swords, and I did a video on it, so I'll link that in the description box and at the top right corner on the eye. So, Ned's death was hard for me. The Red Wedding was harder still. Barristan Selmy, Hodor, they were all hard. But one of the worst deaths for me was one of the first deaths, and that was Lady. It wasn't even a human, it was a direwolf. When Ned put Lady down in the Riverlands, it was awful. Grey Wind, Summer, their deaths were awful. And then Viserion was just gut-wrenching. But I think in season 8, we're just gonna be gutted, and it's gonna be so brutal because the death of magic is going to happen. It's going to be the bittersweet ending, the death of magic. I don't think Game of Thrones ends with dragons still alive, or direwolves for that matter. All of the magical creatures will die, and that process has already started. The giants are almost gone as well. They who were our bane and our brothers. The great lions of the western hills have been slain. The unicorns are all but gone. The mammoths down to a few hundred, the direwolves will outlast us all, but their time will come as well. In the world men have made, there is no room for them or us. So we have seen the magical creatures dying off. When our story starts, magic is just like a legend. Dragons are dead and direwolves are forgotten. There are no more lions in Casterly Rock. The giants are almost gone. We saw dragons reborn into the world, but we've also saw one die. And it's going to be costly to kill that dragon. Some people say the dragon is just a white and that basically Drogon, I guess, could just kill him quite simply with fire. But I don't think it will be be that easy. I think his dragon blood made him different than an average white. He's more like a white walker, and it's gonna be hard to kill him. I believe the answer to stopping the White Walkers is to destroy the magic that moves them. We saw the hive mind thing where the White Walkers die and his whites died too. Beric also tells Jon if he kills the Night King, the rest will die. But something controls the Night King, and if you kill that, it will destroy him. But what is it? It's the Weirwood trees. Destroy the hive network of weirwood trees and you will destroy the Night King. But destroying the weirwood trees will destroy other things as well. It's the magic of the weirwoods that created the Night King. Without that magic, he would die. The First Men may have been onto the concept of this earlier. They were chopping the trees down, and you may think, well, they needed wood. But they weren't just chopping down the trees, they were also burning them. The First Men knew how to defeat the White Walkers. We are led to believe that the Children of the Forest were these saviors that came in and saved the day, but really, it was a mutual benefit. The children would defeat the White Walkers another way in order to save the trees. The mistake was the children never destroyed them. The alliance between the First Men and the children sent them running north, but they were never destroyed. The cost is far too high to destroy them. The children's existence and the children's ancestors' existence are both aligned with the Night King's. So, witnessing the burning of all the weirwoods, the deaths of dragons and wolves, Cersei, she probably won't make it. I doubt she will get killed by a White Walker. Her death will come by the hands of the Valonqar. And sweet Sansa, I don't see her making it. I see her being killed by the White Walkers. She will die in Winterfell. Brienne will die a warrior's death. Jaime will die protecting Rhaegar's son the way he should have protected Rhaenys and Aegon before his father had the Mountain kill them. Varys, Melisandre, Missandei, Grey Worm, fodder for the Night King's army. It's going to be brutal, not just because people are going to die, but the lands that we know as Westeros will be changed forever. No magic, no weirwoods, no direwolves, no visions, no giants, no unicorns, no dragons, no prophecies, no hope. Winter is here. What do you guys think? Is this the bittersweet ending? Are we in for a brutal season 8? I want to know your opinion on this. As always, thanks for watching this video. Huge thank you to everyone that supports me on Patreon. Please like this video if you like it. Please click that subscribe button, hit that notification bell, and join the sweet summer family. Okay, my sweet summer children, have a good day.
Shame.